Can you use an iPad for color grading? The release of Blackmagic's new micro color panel with its excellent iPad compatibility has prompted a lot of conversation. In this video, we're going to demonstrate ideas for how you can use an iPad in legitimate color grading workflows, whether you want to run Resolve directly on your iPad or you want to use it as an extension of your desktop computer. Can I use my iPad for things like scopes? Yes, this is possible on a Mac or Windows PC. It basically involves using your iPad as a second monitor. On Windows, you'll need a third-party app like Duet Display, iDisplay, or Let's View. On a Mac, it's considerably easier as this functionality is built directly into macOS and iOS. It's a feature called Sidecar. In the display settings on your Mac, extend the desktop onto your iPad. And just like that, without connecting cables, it's being used as a second display. Now in Resolve, I've got two options. I can undock the scopes and drag them onto the second monitor, but then I'd have to manually resize and position them. Alternatively, I can go to Workspace, Dual Screen, and select the iPad as my second display. In the color page, scopes and other controls are automatically moved to the second screen. Now my interface is on my primary monitor and my scopes are displayed right in front of my color panel. Pretty cool. Can I use my iPad as a reference display? Yes. Firstly, you could do it by using your iPad as a second display on your computer, just like we did to get the scopes on it. Turn dual screen mode off and instead go to Video Clean Feed and select your iPad. You might need to restart Resolve if you've added your iPad as a second display, but it's not visible in the list. On a Mac, this approach works best when you have the Use Mac Display Color Profiles for Viewers option enabled. Once enabled, macOS will apply the appropriate color management to your viewer image so that it renders correctly on your screen. For example, if you're grading in Rec. 709, but your display is configured for P3, the OS will now color manage the image appropriately. Please note, this is still reliant on your monitor being calibrated and the correct ICC profiles being loaded into your system settings. If you're on a Windows computer and your grading output does not match the color space of your monitors, this approach is significantly more complex and might require the creation of things like calibrated viewing LUTs. Instead of doing it that way, we're going to demonstrate another method that might be better. This doesn't require any additional software. However, this feature does require a DaVinci Resolve Studio license. We're going to use the remote monitoring feature. Ordinarily, this allows you to connect remote clients to view your grade via Blackmagic Cloud. It's a little inefficient though to send your image out to the cloud and then back down through the internet onto your iPad when your iPad and computer are on the same local network. Version 19 of Resolve has added the ability to connect remote monitoring clients directly to your computer via the IP address of your computer. It also has the added advantage of bypassing your Mac's color management. Or, depending on how your Windows computer is configured, your OS's lack of color management. In other words, this is a more foolproof method as you're removing points of failure from your image processing pipeline. Head to Preferences, System, General, and check the Use Remote Monitoring Without Blackmagic Cloud box. Then hit Save. Now, head to Workspace and Remote Monitoring like before. Adjust the codec and bitrate parameters as needed. And don't forget, you're not reliant on internet connection speed, so feel free to set a higher bitrate than you normally would. Now, click Start Session. When connecting directly with an IP address, you don't need a Blackmagic Cloud login on your iPad. That's cool. You need to enable an option in settings, though. Go to your iPad's preferences, find DaVinci Monitor, and enable Use Without Blackmagic Cloud. Now, you can open the app and see no login is needed. Enter the IP address of your computer and hit join. And hey, look at that, you've got an image. There's one more thing though that you'll need to do before using your iPad for grading. A reference display is no good unless it's calibrated. Did you know it's possible to calibrate an iPad Pro display? You'll need software and a colorimeter. Even if you don't have that though, there's a cool setting that you can enable called reference mode. It's under displays and brightness. Advanced. Here it is, Reference Mode. This disables features like True Tone and limits the brightness of your display to 1000 nits for HDR content and 100 nits for SDR content. As DaVinci's remote monitoring utility sends color management data, your iPad will now automatically adjust the brightness of the content to the appropriate standard. Please note, no, calibration does not make the iPad equal in quality to a high-end reference display. But even without calibration, this reference mode makes the iPad Pro a more capable display for color grading. Thus far, we've covered ideas for using an iPad as an accessory for a desktop computer. What about using it as your primary computer, running Resolve directly on it? Can you do serious color grading on a tablet? Well, yes, you can. Here are some reasons why you might decide to use an iPad for your color grading. You're getting the full color page on the iPad version of Resolve. It has excellent feature parity with the desktop version. Now, you should check your particular workflow because there are some codecs that aren't yet supported, but most people won't have a problem. The iPad Pro is phenomenally powerful. It can handle high-resolution files and complex node trees with ease. The iPad Pro has a great display, and as mentioned, it has a reference mode and can be calibrated. Blackmagic Cloud makes it really easy to move projects back and forth between the desktop version of Resolve and an iPad, so there's no need to commit yourself to finishing the entire project on your iPad. Finally, you can even attach external displays. Let me show you. The monitor you've been seeing in this video is the ASUS ProArt PA32 UCXR. It's a 32-inch HDR-capable 1000-nit display with HDMI and Thunderbolt inputs. For color grading, you don't want any old monitor. You want a reference monitor, one that's designed to display an accurate image, not just a good image. This monitor is designed specifically for video editors and colorists. One of its great features is that it has a built-in colorimeter, so you can calibrate it without needing software on your computer. That's especially important as iPads don't have software for calibrating external monitors. We've already calibrated this monitor's HDR presets. We'll connect the iPad via Thunderbolt. This will carry the video signal, but it also allows me to connect peripherals through the monitor like an Ethernet connection and this Motu M4 Audio I/O box. It's also charging my iPad. Let's make sure everything is configured. Again, like previously, let's enable reference mode on the iPad. There's now also options for the external display. We can choose between SDR and HDR. We're going to demonstrate HDR grading, so we'll leave it as is. Now open up Resolve. By default, the external monitor simply mirrors what's on your iPad display. I want to use my external display as a reference monitor. You'll need the studio version of Resolve for this. Click and hold in the viewer and go to Video Clean Feed. So check this out. We've got a calibrated reference display connected to our iPad Pro. Plus, we're even able to monitor audio on professional reference speakers. This setup isn't for everyone, but we think it's pretty cool. Again, to emphasize, this is a studio-only feature. Here's one final thought. Topics like this tend to generate conversation, so please allow us to put things in context. Sony's BVM HX310 costs around $25,000. You'll see monitors like that in high-end professional color suites. To connect the monitor to your computer, you will want a Blackmagic Ultra Studio 4K. That's another $1,000. An iPad costs under $1,000, and it's an entire computer as well. This PA32 UCXR, given its features, is also competitively priced at around $3,000. We've used the phrase reference display when talking about all of these displays. A reference display is one with features that prioritize accuracy. Can an iPad, when correctly configured, and a BVM HX310 both be called reference displays? Yes. In the same way that a Yamaha HS5 that costs around $200 and a Micromain 45 that costs around $3,000 can both be called reference speakers. No, we are not saying that all these monitors provide the same image. More expensive displays will provide a more accurate image. But people have different budgets. The best display is the display you have. And considering that solutions like the ones demonstrated today cost a tenth of the price, but have significantly more than a tenth of the performance, that's pretty awesome. If you have questions, it would be great to hear them in the comments. If you've not yet watched our review of the micro panel, here's a link on screen and in the description. It was fun to build some different setups with the iPad and panel. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If you've decided to learn DaVinci Resolve, consider joining our DaVinci Resolve for Editors course and let us be your guides. And of course, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on future videos. Thanks for watching.